throw ditto last time as they played. And as we get into the contest here, and Killer Mike will be in the white jerseys on defense. So Young Kev coming out with that hot offense. It's going to be strength against strength, offense against defense. And right now, offensively, with the ball first is Young Kev, and he's already down second and 12 behind the sticks. Second and 12 for Young Kev, and he's got Mike Vick looking plenty of time. Defense coming in, and it's caught, and he drops a dime, a dot there on the sideline. You don't see that a lot, and no, it's incomplete.
Yeah, it looks like he can't hang on to the football. That's Herman Moore, but a great play right there. You see that ability that Mike Vick has. It's called the gunslinger ability. He's able to throw the ball a quicker animation. He can throw the ball deep down the field without having to use that long windup animation that most quarterbacks have to do. Another incomplete right there. A lot of times, though, he's able to get the ball out because of that.
Mike Vick starting the ball game 0-for-2 passing. Fourth and 12. Now look, Young Kev, basically he's been aggressive. Offensively, he's been controlling things. This is a different animal here with Killer Mike playing. Exceptional defense so far here in this 2017, Madden 17 Seahawks championship. And he's going for it for Young Kev in the dark blue Seahawks jerseys. Once again, Killer Mike on defense in the white jerseys. It's Young Kev, time running down. He's just snapping it, Mike Vick. Going, and it's tipped, and the pass is incomplete.
Larry.
So Killer Mike's going to get the ball in great field position.
He goes for it on fourth down. He looks like he had a guy to throw to. That is the one downside to Michael Vick. That is the one downside, I would say. He does throw the ball into the back of the helmet of the offensive line sometimes because he throws those balls on a rope. He's not the tallest quarterback in the league. He's about 6'1". But, you know, he does – you do have the tendency for that to happen. If a guy can get a hand up, he's able to swat it down. So that is the one downside if you're throwing those bullet passes with Mike Vick and that gunslinger trait.
There's a sack there for Young Kev playing some good defense there. In all honesty here, Mike Vick's about 5'11", maybe. Now, I don't think he's barely 6 feet, if that. He's probably closer to 5'11". So, yeah, he's going to have some problems seeing over those trees. But the Seahawks have a quarterback that's able to overcome that. So it's been able to be, you know, completed there.
Yeah, and I'll take the good way more than the occasional throwing into the back of a player or throwing it up and it being swatted down. But just then, Young Kip goes for it on fourth down, tries to make the most of that first possession, turns the ball over on down.
Killer Mike looking, and he's going deep, and he's got a receiver on, it's picked off there. What a pick on the sideline there. We're heading back the other way. Young Kip, exceptional defense. Now he's got the ball back again, though, this time inside of his own 5-yard line.
Yeah, that was about a 50-50 ball right there, I thought. And Mike Vick now on offense taking over. Almost throws a pick himself as that one swatted down, almost picked off by the second cornerback back there. So second and 10, but a good defense, a good defensive call there by Young Kid picking it off with Dixon.
Madden 17, Seahawks championship, the championship game here. The final between Young Kev and Killer Mike, the sixth seed, and it is the top overall seed. Young Kev getting it out to the receiver, Deion Sanders, on offense. First and 10 for Young Kev in the dark jerseys, in the gun. Back to throw, once again across the middle of the field, and it's caught this time by the GOAT, and that's a short gain there. I was going to give him one. Don't give him any there. Second and 10.
Yeah, it looks like he may have dropped it, actually. So, you're right. Exactly. It's going to be second and 10, but he's back to this gun tight.
So you got twins to the left, twins to the right. Motions the guy out a little bit further. That's his play. Oh,
there's the heat. That's a fumble. Ball's out.
Get on it. Who's got it? And it's recovered by Young Kip. No, actually, Kip does recover. Yes, it did. Okay, we were right on that.
Woo, Young Kid hangs on to it, but now he's looking at a third and 24, Larry. So that was a big sack and almost could have been much worse there for Young Kid.
Third and 24 for Young Kid here. Yes, he's going to hand it off. No, he fakes it across the middle. Plenty of time. Dart across the middle. Incomplete to Jerry Rice. As you can see, the fans here inside of the Mopop make some noise. 12s. Show everybody what it's all about here in the Pacific Northwest. Rain City. The Emerald City, home of the 12s, and they are out here at the Mopop, the Museum of Pop Culture. Young Kev going to punt the ball away, fourth and 24 inside of his 5. Really good call there. You got Deion Sanders back to return this punt. Showing some speed. He's got something. Running to the right-hand side. Oh, and he's tackled down there. But a really good return for Killer Mike.
Yeah, it's much better than trying to go for it on 4th and 24 from your own, practically from your own end zone. So smartly, he does punt it, but it's tough. You know, Deion Sanders returning the ball on the punt. And so Killer Mike will take over now on the 33 in scoring distance.
First and 10 for Killer Mike. Looking over the middle, and it's caught. No, dropped by Brown. He wasn't able to hold on. Yeah. Second and 10 for Killer Mike as he has the ball at the 37-yard line driving.
Yeah, Tim Brown, a good legend receiver to have in your lineup, but both guys kind of seeing a lot of drops right now, throwing it into traffic, and sometimes you got to just have better patience and keep throwing the ball that you know you can do, and eventually your guys are going to come up with it.
Second and 10, plenty of time, and he's got a receiver wide open in the end zone, and it is caught by Tim Brown. Killer Mike wide open there, catches a receiver in the back of the end zone on the left-hand side, and he's got an early 6-0 lead. Make that 7-0 now for Killer Mike, the sixth seed once again in the championship game, looking to make some noise.
Yeah, Killer Mike, great play there. He finds a wide receiver wide open in the back of the end zone, and that's, you know, the one thing better than throwing it into traffic and trying to catch it is throwing it to a wide open wide receiver, and he does just that, hitting Tim Brown in the end zone. Great play call right there. He saw what Kiv was doing. He called an adjustment. And he made a great throw and a great read to hit that man.
Great read there. And surprised to see him so wide open back in the end zone on that.
Not at all. A lot of these guys know how to set those plays up. And Killer Mike set that play up to perfection. He knew exactly what Kiv was doing on defense and found his man wide open. Just like that, he's up 7-0.
Once again, Mike Vick can't get the completion. That's an incomplete pass. Hits the back of another offensive lineman there. So Kim in an unfamiliar position here, down 7-0, not usually trailing in ball game. So we'll see what he's made of here with the nice blonde salad right there, right?
Yeah, he's had some success in a lot of tournaments. I have every indication that young Kim can come back in this ball game. He has the offense to do so. So this is going to stay close. Young Kim knows how to throw the ball. He throws it, again, like 80% of the time. The guy does not like to run. This time he does run, though, with his quarterback, Mike Vick, getting out of bounds smartly with a 7-yard game, Larry. But, you know, 2nd and 3 now. Young Kiv just has to stay in control. It's only a 7-point game. You don't have to panic right now when you're only down by 7 this early in the ball game.
2nd and 3. He's got a receiver down the left side, and he's got Brown. Oh, and he steps out there. But some pretty good toe drag swag from Kiv, and as long as Kiv can sling that rock around with Michael Vick, he's going to be in this ball game. For Killer Mike, this is the best offense he's going to play in this Madden 17 Seahawks championship.
Yeah, I know young Kiv has his fan base watching back at home on the stream right now, Seahawks.com or twitch.tv/Madden. The youth are watching young Kiv represent the Seahawks, trying to represent them. Have you in the Madden 17 Club Series Championship, which will be on April 15th. He wants to represent the Seahawks. He knew when these came out, when these Club Series representations came out, he wanted to rep the Seahawks. As we said, he's right up the road, just right outside of Seattle, a native right here.
Ooh, good hit there.
Gotta
good
be
tackle.
Careful about those with Mike Vick. He can cough up the football, especially if you take a hit stick fumble. All these guys at this high level, they're not just making shoestring tackles. They know when and where to use the hit stick, and these guys know which guys have the most hit power to do that.
Old man Willie Brown right there making the tackle. 3rd and 1 for young Kiv. Oh, on the QB sneak. He does not get it there. So 4th and 1. AJ, what call do you make here if you're young Kiv? Do you take the points or do you go aggressive?
You know, young Kiv is going to go for it 100%. I think he knows he has a 4th and 1 play up his sleeve. He generally does. He tries the little run there up the middle. And Killer Mike, of course, had a play to stop it. So he comes out back in the gun tight. And I think he's got a play for this.
Mike Vick looking in the end zone. Oh, and it's knocked away and batted away.
Not the play I would have liked to have seen. No. I can't believe it. Young Kiv thought he had his man. You see that little pulse of green underneath the player, Mike Vick, that indicates that he is throwing a bullet pass. So when he does that, that means he is triggering that gunslinger ability and throwing a bullet pass. And right there, he throws a bullet into the back of the end zone, but there was a defender there to swat it down.
Once again, there's only a limited amount of players that have that gunslinger, Brett Favre being one of them, and also Michael Vick as well, that quick action and just strong arm that both of those players possess there. So Young Kim down 7-0 on defense now, where he's comfortable. He's got a good defensive game plan and scheme against Killer Mike, who actually is better on the defensive side of the ball, but he's proven in this championship, the Madden 17 Seahawks championship, and he's got Julio down the middle of the field.
Right. Julio Jones, yeah, with a big grab there on the possession catch, picking up the first down. Derek Carr, his quarterback. And, you know, we've talked about Mike Vick a lot. We talk about Herman Moore and some of these guys. It might be confusing if you're new to Madden Ultimate Team. Which Mike Vick are we talking about? Well, we're not talking about the Michael Vick that just retired as a backup quarterback. No, we are talking about a throwback Michael Vick, and that is indicated in his ratings. He's a 98 overall player rating. So that is a guy that we have taken, you know, given you the ability to play with the Michael Vick from 2004. You see on the player item, when you see that card pop up, that is in his Falcons uniform. So that's from about 04, 05, and that's why Michael Vick has those high ratings here for Young Kid. But right now, Killer Mike making use of that Derek Carr Team of the Year quarterback. And he's doing a great job. He knows exactly what he's doing. He's moving the ball down the field very methodically and, you know, really kind of controlling this ball game against the best player so far in this tournament.
Is that Michael Vick 04? Was that the best Madden player ever?
Easily. There's no question.
Okay.
Michael Vick is the best Madden player of all time. You can't imagine how hard he was for guys. We got guys like Justin Chow, who works at EA now. He is here this week. He used to just wreak havoc with Mike Vick and the Falcons back in older Madden. So that is a guy that was tough to stop back on the PS2 days. And he is easily the most popular player. When that item comes out in Madden Ultimate Team, he's everybody's favorite.
Wow, that's saying something. And that's been the talk around the community that I've seen you tweet it out, and just, you know, you look back at those old Madden 04 games, and Michael Vick, I mean, it's like Bo Jackson and the old
Towers. Oh, there's a big pick
by Paul Krause there, and we're heading the other way, and how about this? Killer Mike, once again, bowing his neck on defense, saying, you're not going to move the ball against me, and he's proving to be a tough cookie here in this Madden 17 Seahawks edition of the championship.
Yeah, and Killer Mike was the recipient of a nice bad pass there by Mike Vick. It's a rare occurrence, but especially when you put him under pressure. One thing you need to know if you're new to Madden or if you're just starting playing, when you have a quarterback, if he is under pressure, if there is a linebacker or a cornerback or a defensive end within striking range of your quarterback, you are going to throw more inaccurate passes. That means they are under pressure. You will see that indicator on the bottom of the screen in red as he throws a bullet pass right there, doesn't complete it. But Larry, when you see that, you know, a guy, if he's throwing on the run, he's more likely to throw an incomplete pass. And I think Mike Vick was a little bit under pressure. He throws a pick, and now we see Killer Mike on the offensive drive.
Third and 9 for Killer Mike. Back to throw. Oh, watch out. He's got the Sam. Oh, he's sacked, and it's fumbled, and it's picked up by his offensive lineman, who was knocked down on his behind there. You were giving shout-outs, and you were talking about Chow. I also want to give a shout-out to our guy. Really would be hard to do this without Travis Smith working really hard back there. My buddy in crime back there on the road doing a good job with the dev kit. And Travis knows what I'm talking about there, bringing the equipment around, making this thing set up.
It's a lot of hard work. A lot of stuff goes into bringing these tournaments to life. And it's exceptional work this week. This Seahawks championship here at this Challenger event has been incredible. I mean, the stage is awesome. You've all seen it back at home. And right now, Young Kiv forcing the punt, doing a good job. Now back on offense, and he's only down by 7.
Watch out on the backhand side there. And you were talking about these guys and what they've been able to do. We were here yesterday as they set up the guys, you know, James and everybody from ESL, Dwayne Smith and those guys working hard during the rehearsal and setting things up yesterday. So great job by ESL. Also Travis Smith and our guys at EA Sports. The commish, got to give them a shout out as well. Once again, this club series for Matt Marcoux has been phenomenal running these club series and seeing these different venues here. My third one now was at Minnesota and also Buffalo. And this one right here, top notch. As you've got live here, you've got the 12s here. So that makes it that much more special. And he's got a receiver down the left-hand side, and it is Brown. And here comes Young Kiv with that offense. A little hurry-up action here, trying to get back into this ball game with 3 minutes left in the second quarter.
Yeah, he is moving the ball well now. And once again, like with all the plays that Killer Mike has been able to make, you would
Mike
think
up the middle.
Yeah, you would think this would be a bigger blowout, but he's still only up by seven. Young Kiv right in this. He has plenty of time, and he still obviously has Mike Vick, as you see him scramble right there for a first down. We're still very early in this ball game. 2:40 left here in the second quarter.
First and goal for Young Kiv. 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter. Mike Vick under center at the 7-yard line. Back to pass. Takes off, and he's running to the left-hand side, and he's got it to the end zone. And that's a scrambled touchdown for Mike Vick. And we are 1 point after attempt away from being tied up. It's up, and it is good. So with 2 minutes, 24 seconds remaining in the first half of play, Killer Mike 7, Young Kiv 7 points on the board as well. AJ, we're brand new tied at 7, brother.
Yeah, absolutely. Deion Sanders going to take this one out right there on the goal line. He brings it out to the 25-yard line, but 2:20 left here in the first half. Still plenty of time for both these guys, but good job by Young Kiv to force the punt, play good defense, and then score, make use of that possession and score a touchdown to tie this ball game up.
Killer Mike back, throwing the rock.
That was almost an interception.
Yes, it
was. Could have been an interception. Deion Sanders was right on his heels. He does complete it to Jordan Cameron, but sometimes you do see them jump that ball and intercept it. So close call there by Killer Mike.
All right, you got trips to the right there. You got Julio Jones on the back side, and we've gotten into the 2-minute warning there. Seven ball game here. Killer Mike at the lead. Young Kibbs come back to tie the score up. 7-7, 2 minutes left in the first half. Killer Mike back to throw. Watch out, got a receiver. Oh, what a catch, and he could not hold on to it. Julio Jones almost brought it down with a one-handed catch.
Yeah, it's tough to come down with those one-handed balls, especially when you're throwing into traffic. There were about two defensive backs back there to break the ball off, but you know, Julio Jones can come down with them sometimes. He gets those animations. We talk about competitive Madden players talking about you know, the meta, and they say, you know, he just gets those animations. That Julio Jones definitely gets them.
Got a receiver on the right-hand side on the wheel route, and he's got his running back Coleman down the right-hand side. Killer Mike in business in Young Kiv's territory.
Yeah, we see him run the wheel route, the halfback wheel, outside of the backfield and upfield. Tevin Coleman, great speed by that running back, and he gets upfield for the first down. This time, Derek Carr shrugs
off
the sack.
He's got a sack on him, and he's got Coleman once again out of the backfield on the right-hand side, inside of the 5-yard line. Killer Mike doing it again on offense.
Yeah, he's playing with fire a little bit right now, shrugging off a sack there, but he backpedals, gets his composure. Derek Carr throws a strike to his wide receiver, picks up another first down, and now he's inside the 5-yard line.
So about a minute 18 left in the game, 1:16 ticking down. First and goal for Killer Mike. Trying to run some clock. Play clock is down to 2. High throw, and it is a touchdown completed. Toe drag swag into the end zone. That's a touchdown for Killer Mike. Gets another touchdown right before the end of the first half, pinning the extra point. Extra point, it's snapped, it's up. Right down Broadway, and it is good. 14-7 score with about a minute left in the first half.
Yeah, we've talked about the Madden GOAT, which is Michael Vick. Let's talk about what many call the real NFL GOAT. That is Jerry Rice. Jerry Rice at wide receiver, lined up for Killer Mike. He comes down with it in the end zone for the touchdown. So big play there to take the lead here before the half. Young Kiv still has plenty of time to work with and all three of his timeouts, which he cannot take to the second half with him. So he's going to use those and be able to utilize those here on this drive. But he starts at the 25, Larry.
First and 10. Young Kiv once again trailing in this ball game. Can he find a way to tie it up again? And he's looking for Mike Vick. Plenty of space. Throws it out of bounds. So Mike Vick so far, under 50% completion percentage there. 7 of 18, under 100 yards, does have the pick as well. Young Kibbs looking to pick it up with Mike Vick, the Madden GOAT from the early to mid-2000s there down in the ATL with the Falcons. Second and 10 for Young Kibbs in the dark jerseys. Mike Vick looking, sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney.
Yeah, big backside pressure there to Jadeveon Clowney. Gets the block shed off the right tackle and gets the sack. He's got so much speed. A lot of these guys line him up at defensive tackle sometimes because he's able to block shed a lot of times, especially when you're tanking your offensive line. So big sack there by Jadeveon Clowney. There's a lot of pressure coming from that right side, and it depends on what Young Kibbs can do. Put extra blockers over there. That time it comes through the gaps. But he lets loose of the football, Larry, just in time. But he had a double gap blitz there on that play, both the linebackers. So it all depends on how Young Kibbs is able to pick up those blitzes. We see these guys running corner blitzes all the time. They try to get extra guys on that outside edge. And you just have to move running backs over there and tight ends and extra players to try and pick it up.
Fourth and one here. Huge play for Young Kibbs. Got plenty of space. And he's throwing. That's out of bounds. That's not a completion. So it's going over on downs for Killer Mike. No toe drag swag for Young Kibbs. And Killer Mike will take over at the 34-yard line. 37 seconds left here to try to build on this lead. He's got Coleman right up the middle, running hard right into the red zone. Oh, what a gain there, about 16, 17 yards for Coleman, right up the gut for Killer Mike.
Yeah, Killer Mike with a good defensive stop there. I think Young Kibbs kind of made a mistake. I think he should have run the ball with Mike Vick. He has all three of his timeouts. That's why you go out and get a Michael Vick. He had some gaps there in the offensive line. He could have run for that first down. He has completed that pass many times before. That corner route is usually there. That sideline throw, that time Mike Vick just throws it just out of bounds. And it's incomplete, can't get both feet in, doesn't give his wide receiver a chance to catch it. So now Killer Mike back on offense here, second and 10.
Looking into the corner, and it's caught. Was that the GOAT, Jerry Rice?
I believe it was.
I think it was, yeah, that is a completion on the corner route. He caught Jerry Rice down there. So now, here we go, 4 seconds left, first and goal. Oh boy, do you try to go for the touchdown or you take the three and try to make this a two-score game going into halftime?
Yeah, that was really close, Larry. I thought he might have had a touchdown. It looks like the ball did not cross the plane. So, and then he drops down and is carried backwards. His momentum carries him backwards a little bit. He's brought out at the 2-yard line, but 3 seconds left. Jerry Rice this time.
That's a great play. I saw that Jerry Rice was lined up in the slot, uncovered, no defender near him. I knew he was going to throw it right there. Great play by Killer Mike, and the extra point is good, and it's a 21-7 game, and he still has 2 seconds left. So it was the quick pop pass, and he gets into the end zone.
Yeah, it's a tough break if you're Young Kibbs. Mike Vick, you expect him to make all those throws deep down the field. He was under a little bit of pressure, so a little bit of an inaccurate pass, and you know Herman Moore can't drag his feet, can't make the catch on the sidelines, and that turned in to turning the ball over on downs, which gave Killer Mike a chance to score and only give Young Kibbs 2 seconds here in the first half.
21-7 lead, last play of the first half.
There's a fumble.
That's a fumble, that's a live ball. And it's recovered.
That could have been a lot worse for Young Kibbs right there. He luckily falls on top of it. But if he could have given up a fumble for 6, and that would potentially put the game out of reach going in the second half.
So it'd be Killer Mike doing the daily double there, getting the touchdown right before half. Gets the second half kickoff. If he can try to punch this thing in, then he's feeling pretty good about his chances to move on to be the Madden 17 Seahawks champion. First and 10, Killer Mike in control of the ball game with the ball on offense.
As you see him moving that running back left and right, he's trying to decide which side to run to and decide sometimes throwing his opponent off. On which guy he's trying to block, which side he's trying to block on that outside blitz. That time he was just flipping the play, trying to figure out which side he wanted to run to. But you see him move those running backs to different sides when they see that nickel blitz coming.
Killer Mike got plenty of time. Look, watch out. Is that a live ball? No, it's not. It's an incompletion. Barely gets it off. Derek Carr avoiding the sack there. Third and nine now for Killer Mike. Play call, what are you looking at? If you're Killer Mike, AJ,
you know,
we're running the ball, we're throwing the ball, you have a lead. How aggressive should he be?
Third and nine, he's been throwing the ball very well so far in this game. He got Derek Carr and all those wide receivers, those legends like Julio Jones, Tim Brown. He's got Jerry Rice out there who has a couple touchdowns. So I think, yeah, he's definitely throwing it right here. The pressure comes, though.
Got it off, and it's Tim Brown there with the reception across the middle of the field. Killer Mike making all of the big plays when he's absolutely having to make them, AJ.
Yeah, he comes out in that shotgun wide trips. Shotgun gun wide trips formation. He believes he can make the best reads out of that formation. So that's why we're seeing him use that a lot. He likes the reads that he can make. He likes the different plays that he can call out of that gun wide trips form. So he's playing with that a lot. You see these guys, and some people watch at home and they're like, this guy runs the same play over and over. They are not running the same play. They are running a similar formation or the same formation, and they're running different plays out of that formation, trying to keep their opponents on their toes.
And there's a dot right down the middle of the field to Jordan Cameron, and once again, matriculating the ball down the field. The four-year veteran in the Air Force. We can't just say it enough. The command post controller in the Air Force, doing his thing, shocking the world here as a six seed, hands it off to his fullback up the gut. That's a gain. We're going to call it a loss of one.
Yeah, the gun, back to that gun, but it looks like he's not going to pick it up. So 5-yard line now. He's had these plays in his playbook. This Jerry Rice, he usually likes to throw this quick post over the middle, throw it up top to Jerry Rice, who can come down with it in traffic. High catch and traffic rating.
This could be the game right here. Second and goal, a run up the middle. Coleman stuffed there. None-yard game, maybe even a loss of about a half a yard. So if you're Killer Mike, got an opportunity to go up three scores here, three touchdowns, maybe almost put the game away.
That would be a statement, absolutely. You have taken down two juggernauts already in this tournament, and he's on his way to taking down the number one seed in Young Kiv. He's played exceptional, absolutely exceptional on offense and defense, forced his opponent to make bad throws, picked him off, forced turnovers, and he's done a great job.
Did you notice the last two play calls as the field goal is up and good? Now Killer Mike with a three-score lead, up by 17, 24-7. You notice those last two play calls, very conservative. Why can he be conservative? First, he's in the lead. Secondly, he likes his defense.
Yeah, he absolutely should like his defense.
This one's broken. How about this? Can
you like
that?
Look at this, Young Kiv.
Young Kiv with the kickoff, the return, and he's back in the ball game. Needed a big play, and he got the big play. Returns the kickoff all the way back into the zone. Young Kiv says, not so fast, my friends. PAT up, and it's good. 24-14, just like that. Doesn't have to play against the defense of the special
absolutely
teams.
Absolutely huge return there. You cannot ask for a better play. Returning the ball with Tim Brown. Tim Brown, great return man. He has that ability, the energizer ability, which allows him to make juke moves and not run out of stamina. So that's why a lot of guys have him in their lineup. He's also a great wide receiver, but you can put him at kick return so he does not run out of stamina as fast as other players. And right there, he holds on to it, keeps his feet all the way up the field with all those juke moves. Young Kiv does a great job of finding the holes and returning that for a touchdown. Now Mike takes over at the 25.
So Mike takes over at the 25. Killer Mike.
Almost throws a pick there.
Yeah, look, he's got to be careful. Look, you're in control. Be careful. You have the lead. Do the things that you've done to get to this point. Defensively, you're constricting things, putting pressure on, tighten up the special teams, and get back to doing things that you're comfortable with on offense, and that is spreading the ball out and throwing your version of dots as well. That's what Killer Mike's been doing as the sixth seed from Costa Mesa, California. Got a receiver looking, and he's going to run with Derek Carr. Plenty of space there. Picks up 15 yards. Easily gets a first down there. Good recognition.
Yeah, Derek Carr has just enough speed to pick up a first down. He is not going to beat you a ton with his legs, but he does have enough being a young quarterback for the Raiders. He is doing pretty well right now. He's throwing dots down the field. That's why you want him in your lineup behind center. So Derek Carr picks up the first down right there. Great run and great awareness by Killer Mike.
First and 10 for Killer Mike with a 10-point lead. Late stages of the third quarter. Killer Mike looking back. Oh, what a throw by Julio and a catch by Julio Jones. You see him coming in on the dig route. He threw it before he even got out of the cut in between the safeties and the linebackers there. That cover two coverage.
Yeah, great play there. Great read as he picks up another first down. And Young Kiv has to find a way to put pressure on Derek Carr. But right now, you know what? Killer Mike is doing a great job of picking up those nickel blitzes and those blitzes the Young Kiv is sending. And he has all the time in the world to throw these passes with Derek Carr. And when you give him time, he can make them.
I wonder if Killer Mike was hiding the fact that offensively, he only talked about defense and his strengths and his weaknesses. Wouldn't even want to talk about offense. That tipped me off right there to say, this guy feels good about his offense. And he's going the other way. Was that a fumble or was that a pick? Anyway, it's Deion Sanders. You know you're not going to catch him. All the way the other way.
Huge,
90 yards.
Huge play.
Me?
And finally, we see some emotion from Young Kiv over there. He's been stone-faced the entire game. And finally, even on the kick return, he did not even smile.
Wow.
I'd like to see a smirk, but this time you see him, a little bit of that emotion. He started to stay, you know, a little bit more composure. He's gotten real emotional in tournaments in the past. This time he stays composed. And a nice turnover return for a touchdown. Just like that, he is within three, and this is a great ball game.
14-point swing there. Instead, Killer Mike had a chance to go up by, 17? Now he's only up by three. So Young Kiv not only gets the score, didn't have to use any offensive time there, gets the turnover on downs, gets the possession back. Folks, we've got a ball game as we head down towards the later stages of the third quarter before heading into the fourth quarter. Killer Mike, once again, what is he going to do after a couple of bad possessions, a couple of different things that went against him here in the third quarter, where probably should be up by about three scores now. He's only up by one score.
Yeah, you saw Tevin Coleman there win that tackle battle as he catches the ball. He breaks away from it. When you see that button prompt come up, you got to hit that button first before the defense can hit theirs to get a nice broken tackle, and he does it right there to pick up a couple extras, but he's still looking at a second and seven now.
Second and seven. Watch out from the backside. Barely gets it off Derek Carr. Had a great start now, but the last two picks for Derek Carr, he's got three touchdowns, but Young Kiv doing a great job on the defensive side of the ball. He's starting to tighten up a little bit. Back into this ball game, down just 3 points, 24-21. Time winding down here in the third quarter. Killer Mike, huge, important third and seven here for Killer Mike.
Yeah,
in the gun with Derek Carr.
Saw another legend get in there and break up the play there, get to the quarterback, and that was Charles Haley. So a lot of legends in these lineups. A great reason to go out and play Madden Ultimate Team. You get to a nice mix of legends and current players. There's a big play to another legend.
Can Richard Sherman catch him? He's not going to get him. Oh,
too much speed.
Jerry Rice to go down the right sideline. How about this on the teeter-totter? Mr. AJ there, the seesaw, back and forth we go. And now it's Killer Mike with 4 seconds left in the third, up by 10 points, 31-21.
Larry,
Killer Mike with the lead.
It is just an emotional roller coaster in this game right now. Huge play after huge play, and somebody's got to come up with a stop. Nice play there, though, by Killer Mike to get the touchdown, throwing to his legend wide receiver, Jerry Rice.
Absolutely. Now the momentum back on the side of Killer Mike. He needed that after that long turnover and score by Young Kiv to get within three. Back to where we basically started before all of that madness began there about 5 minutes ago. Young Kiv with the ball down 10. He's in the dark blue Seahawks jerseys. Back, Michael Vick. Watch out, coming down the middle.
Lots of heat. Lots
down.
Of heat.
Was that Lane? Is that Night Train?
Yeah, he sent a nice blitz there up the seams, and he goes through the gaps, shoots the gaps, gets to the quarterback, and you've got to do that. You've got to consistently put pressure on Mike Vick, or he will beat you all day with his legs or his arm.
Oh, another tackle. A fumble, and it's picked up and recovered by Khalil Mack. Killer Mike making plays. After being up only three, gets the long touchdown pass, and now he takes the ball back, the possession back, with the ball now, looking to go back up 17 where it should have been probably 5 minutes ago, AJ.
Yeah, absolutely. Huge play there. He gets to the quarterback again, and Young Kiv has said it before. He has trouble picking up blitzes right
there. Especially up the middle.
Yeah, Mike sends that blitz, and it gets to Mike Vick, and he coughs up the football, and they don't hang on to it every time. Sometimes they fumble the football, and that time he turns it back over to Killer Mike, who is just in the driver's seat of this football game right now.
Will we see another one seat go down, and he's up the middle? Coleman into the end zone. How about this, AJ? We've had four now. Madden, 17 Club Series championships, and the first three, none of the one seeds have won the tournament. Are we going to make it 4-for-4 here in Seattle?
I think we might. We might so far. You know, these guys coming in here, you think it's easy. It's never easy to win a game of Madden, especially at this level. Even though you're talking about eight guys and a lot of different seeding in between, just because you're the one seed, Killer Mike obviously has put in the work too. All these guys,
absolutely,
these top eight, have put in the work online. You have to put in that work to actually get here. So, no, I think anybody can beat anybody on, as you've said, any given Thursday, because it is a Thursday night. But, you know, like they say in the NFL, any given Sunday, and that's the same here in competitive Madden.
Oh, I thought he had the A button there running down the middle of the seam. He could have hit him a little early. Failed to hit him there, so he goes to the left side and completes a 7-yard pass. And when you look at it, I mean, you gotta give a lot of credit to Killer Mike. All of these things going against him, probably should have been up by at least 3 scores. Finds himself in a 3-score game, and now he's got it back up to 17 as we get through the fourth quarter, looking to be the fourth straight non-number one seed to move on and win a Club Series championship.
Yeah, the only problem with Kiv's game so far in this one has been he's relied on big plays over and over again. He had that kick return for a touchdown. You can't rely on those the entire game. You have to consistently move the ball down the field. And Young Kiv, I think he can do that. I think he has the ability to do that. So he's only down right now, but he has the ability to come back. He's down by 17,
look,
but he's got Mike
Vick.
Look at that as he scrambles. He's got plenty of time in all his timeouts. Let's see what he can do with this.
If you're a Young Kiv, you need to score and you need the ball back. You need to steal some possessions. If you're Killer Mike, keep everything in front of you. Don't do anything crazy and just hold on to the ball. You've got a shot and it's caught by Brown there inside the 10-yard line. Here comes Young Kiv. You know he's not going to just give up and roll over.
Absolutely not. And that is a nice, huge play to get it down to the 5-yard line by Young Kiv, keeping his drive alive. I'd like to see him score right here really quick and then get the ball back.
First and goal for Young Kiv, down trailing 38-21. As you can see, we're getting closer towards the 2-minute warning. 2:35 remaining in the fourth quarter. Young Kiv hands it off, fakes the handoff. Mike Vick back running, trying to get into the end zone. He's gonna come up short, hit by two players on the defensive side for Killer Mike.
Yeah, and you can tell Young Kiv is leaving it all on the field right now. He is playing with a lot of risk, running the ball with Mike Vick, not sliding to the ground, but he has to do that right now. He has to put points on the board, and he's got to take every
toss,
risk.
Sweep.
He
no,
knows
he's
how
not going
to
get in. We've got a fourth and goal call here. What do you do, Mr. AJ?
You have to go for it. He's got a fourth down play. He's going to kick the field goal right now. He's going to make it a two-possession game, which is actually smarter than I would have chosen, but you know, that makes it a 14-point game, so that's a good decision. He's going to need 3 points at some point, down by 3 possessions, but he's only left himself 2 minutes, and he's got to give the ball back to Killer Mike, who has been absolutely unstoppable on offense. He's got 38 points against one of the best Madden players in the country, so you need a big stop here.
So for Young Kiv there, you get the field goal, you're down 14. Why didn't you onside kick there?
You know, he probably just thinks he's got all his timeouts. He can do this. He can contain and potentially stop Killer Mike. He might be thinking Killer Mike is going to turn the ball over. He's going to run the ball, it looks like. And Young Kiv, as we said, he has all 3 of his timeouts. So he's going to wait to go for the onside kick. He has no pressure in doing that right now. You don't want to go for the onside kick until you absolutely have to. These guys come into these games and, you know, getting an onside kick is very rare. It's very difficult to do. So he doesn't want to force that until he has to. So he's going to use his timeouts right now, try to contain this run, but it looks like he's not going to do it. So the clock is going to keep running, and Young Kiv is going to hold on to that second timeout, it looks like. But that's why he didn't go for the onside kick right there, because he didn't have to. He had three timeouts.
Well, we saw in the Vikings Club Series out there at the Mall of America that drag down 18 with about a minute or two left. He got an onside kick, so it can happen. But you're right. It sometimes takes a miracle to try to pull that off.
Yeah, it's not easy. You got to rely on a guy dropping the ball or the bounce going your way. There are ball physics in Madden NFL 17, so you need the ball to bounce your way on an onside kick, just like you do in the real NFL. But they're rare to come by. You know, you put the hands team out there, especially, and your receivers, and you've got a lot of legends. You've got Deion Sanders and Julio Jones, which you're not able to do on Sunday, put all those legends and current players in the hands team. So it's tough to get an onside kick. He doesn't go for it there, but he's going to play defense and call his timeouts and try to contain Killer Mike, get the ball back with a little bit of time, and then potentially, you know, cross that bridge when he gets to it, as to say, you know, he needs to score a seven real quick before he even really even thinks about going for an onside kick.
So here we go. Killer Mike, 38-24 lead, 30-13. You've got it. Do you go for the aggressive play and get a pass, or do you run it here knowing that you might be able to take some time off the clock? Of course, you run it there up the gut, and it is stopped by Young Kiv, but he's going to run off 30, 40 seconds here.
Yeah, he's going to continue to let the clock just chew up here in the last quarter.
Look at him. He's thinking how close I am to that $2,500 check. Those four tickets to a 2017 Seahawks home game, the $500 gift certificate to the pro shop, the sideline passes pregame also as well. A lot on the line for Killer Mike.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for Young Kiv. He's got plays up his sleeve that he can go to, but it's going to be tough to score 14 here with 35 seconds. Let's see what he can do with Deion Sanders on the punt return. Deion Sanders stopped at the 46, Larry, but, you know, Michael Clark, a.k.a. Killer Mike, told me beforehand he was really excited about that prize pool that you just talked about. That was the biggest thing motivating him here in this tournament. And one of the reasons why is he doesn't have a ton of series points yet, but he's picking some up. He's coming in here with nothing to lose. And who knows, we might see this guy run away with it and win the Madden Club Series Championship right, representing the Seahawks, and then make his way into the top 32 at the end of the year and make it to the Madden Championship, where there is $500,000 of prize pool on the line.
Wouldn't that be something, though, to come out of nowhere with no points, get into the Club Series, you win that specific club, you get out to L.A. area in Burbank in April, you win the Club Series Championship, $50,000, you move on to the Madden Championship Series, and $500,000 on the line there as Young Kiv trying to get into the end zone. It's going to take a miracle here. Not enough time, and it looks like Killer Mike is going to leave the MoPop, the Museum of Pop Culture, in a shocker as the champion. Last few seconds here, 6 seconds left for Young Kiv. He's got Michael Vick looking into the end zone, and it is caught. It's a touchdown. Any time left to even have a shot?
He's got two seconds for an onside kick. There's something. So nice play there by Young Kiv. He does exactly what he has to do. That's about all you can expect. But now he knows. This is, like I said, he used all his timeouts. Now he has to try to go for the onside kick. He has no other choice.
Here it is, the onside kick. Killer Mike in white. He needs a recovery, and it's the game over. Oh, he dropped it, and it's going the other way. He's going to have 1 second left. Oh, my gosh, this is just like
Killer
the Viking series.
Killer Mike did end up recovering that, so he ended the game right there.
Killer Mike recovered it.
But you were right. That was very close.
Woo!
That was very close. Young Kiv almost picked the ball up, and the ball bounced around. That's exactly the bounce
that
you want.
And that is the ball game, and how about that? Four Club Series, four number one seeds failing to win it all, and there's your champion in the dark blue Seahawks jersey. It is Killer Mike, the Air Force veteran, 4 years, the command post controller, winning from Costa Mesa, California. How about that? He wins the Madden 17 Seahawks Championship. No one saw this coming, the sixth seed. You didn't see it coming. I didn't see it coming. But now looking back on it, when I talked to him about offense, he didn't want to say anything about it. He had something up his sleeve.
Yeah, and that's a huge win by Killer Mike. He is going to advance on to the Club Series Championship. He will represent the Seahawks now, coming from California, but he is representing the Seahawks in that Club Series Championship. And I don't think I would wish anything better if I'm a Seahawks guy, because they have a great player now representing them in that Club Series final, because he has been incredible. I can see him running the table in that one and winning it all.
Wow, that is saying something there.
Yeah. So his offense and defense were fantastic.
Complimentary.
I mean, you can't question. He's been great.
All right, so we're going to the main stage here. You've got your Madden 17 Seahawks champion. He is Killer Mike from Costa Mesa, California, and he's standing by with Jackie Montgomery now on the main stage. Jackie, take it away.
Thanks, Larry and AJ. First off, let's give a huge round of applause for local boy, Young Kev, coming down from Edmonds, Washington, our runner-up here today. Great, great game between you guys. All right, so Killer Mike, I gotta ask you, what was going through your mind when Young Kev pulled within 3 points of you?
I just tell myself to stay calm, and as long as I just follow the game plan and stick to it, I should be fine.
Now, you said that he had the best offense coming into today's game. How'd you shut him down in that fourth quarter to maintain your lead and get the win?
I was just doing what I normally done, and it just happened to work. I noticed he got the kick return touchdown, and he got the fumble for a touchdown, so I was able to keep his offense locked up with what I normally do.
Now you're going home with some big prizes, including $2,500, and you'll be playing in the championship representing the Seahawks. How excited are you for that?
It feels great. I thank the Seahawks for this opportunity, and I'm going to win.
All right, well, with that being said, let's bring up Blitz and the Seagals, who have your custom Seahawks Madden championship jersey and hat. All right, 12, let's give it up for your Madden 17 Seahawks Club Series champion, Killer Mike. Woo!
Oh, my goodness. You saw the streamers coming through.
Yeah, the cannon. They got the confetti cannon out here at the Mopop. Yeah, a little pop here at the Mopop. But fantastic game. Can't say it enough
about
this competitor. Yeah, Killer Mike walking away with the W.